गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ 10th स्टैंडर्ड, वी आर बैक विद हिस्ट्री एंड पॉलिटिकल साइंस एंड वी हैव बीन डीलिंग विद दिस सेकेंड लेसन इन पॉलिटिकल साइंस. नाउ फर्स्ट थिंग विच आई वॉन्ट टू नो, हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू हैव गॉट द राइट टू वोट? नो वन हैज़ द राइट टू वोट. व्हाई यू आर नॉट हैविंग द राइट टू वोट? ओके, बिकॉज यू आर not 18 years of age. Okay, if you are 18 years of age, you can vote, correct? Suppose you are staying in America, can you vote in India? Why not? Yes, because you are not an Indian citizen. Those who are an Indian citizen and those who are above the age of 18 only can vote. All boys and girls can vote. Means all men and women of every religion, of all the caste? Yes, all those who are Indian citizen, born in India and are Indian citizen and above the age of 18 have the right to vote. So in voting there are two things. Okay, earlier there was something and now voting. Is there any process? How these parties are formed and who gives them the right? And how these campaigns are done? So there is something called Election Commission, and they have some rights with them. They can give, they accept the party names, and they give the permission to choose their candidates. And everything is done. There is a process where they have to file in the election list to the Election Commission. Then there is something called voters list, who has the right to vote. All the details are there, how the election is conducted, in which states, how it is conducted. And you know, earlier there was something called ballot box, where you used to put for the finger the ink, and we used to put and on paper used to get, we used to stamp, and then we used to put that in the ballot box. Now there is something called EVM, electronic machine. Okay, EVMs have come. So now we have to just press the button. Now there is something called EVM pad. When you press the button on EVM machine, we can see what we have done in the what it comes in the EVM pad. We get the receipt. Okay. So these all things are there. So today we shall deal with the next chapter. Something is called electoral process. Elections have played a major role in the working of India's democracy. Elections and representation are two very important processes in democracy. We know that people's representatives are selected through elections. Elections help to bring a change in power through peaceful means. Different political parties get an opportunity to rule. Policies of the government and life of society also changes. We expect that the representatives we elect should be efficient, honest and trustworthy, and they should respect the opinion of people. The electoral process should also be free, fair and reliable. To ensure that, the Constitution of India has made provision for an independent election commission to administer the election process in India. The Election Commission of India and the state election commission conduct all important elections in our country. The entire process of elections, from declaring the date of elections to the declaration of results, is carried out under the direction and control of Election Commission. The election process is an inseparable component of a comprehensive democratic process. In this chapter, we will understand the structure, functions and role of the Election Commission. We will also discuss the reforms required to be made in the electoral process. Election Commission. In India, the Election Commission is central to the process of elections. Article 324 of the Indian Constitution has established this autonomous body, which consists of one chief election commissioner and two other commissioners. How much is there? Autonomous body which consists of one chief election commissioner and two other commissioners. Okay, which is Article 324 of Indian Constitution. Then the president appoints the election commissioner. Who appoints? The president, not the prime minister. The Chief Election Commissioner cannot be removed from his post easily or on account of any political reasons. This is necessary so as to preserve the independence of Election Commission. There is a separate provision made for the expenses of Election Commission. The Election Commission does not have a separate staff. Government officers, teachers and other employees help the Election Commission to execute the process of election. They do not have separate staff, but who? Government officers and teachers. Because the government pays this government officers and teachers the lump sum amount, big salary. So then they are made to work for that. Function of Election Commission. Preparing the, now what are the functions of Election Commission? What is their duty? Preparing the voters list. Every Indian citizen who has completed 18 years of age has a right to vote, as I said before. To exercise the right to vote, citizen's name must be in the voters list. Since I don't have the voter card, voter ID, I cannot go and just elect. I should have the voters list. It is a responsibility of the Election Commission to prepare the list of eligible voters, update the existing voters list and include the names of new voters. Now there are new people who become 18 years, they should be added. There are people who have died and gone, so their name should be deleted. The Election Commission has the authority to issue identity cards to the voters. Decide the timetable and the program of elections. The conduct of election is entirely the responsibility of the Election Commission. The Election Commission decides when to conduct elections and in how many stages to hold elections in every state. Third, scrutiny of the applications of candidates. After the election dates are declared, every political party selects the candidates to contest elections. Some candidates contest the elections independently without the support of any political party. Candidates of political parties as well as independent candidates have to fill the applications which include the information about their own self. The Election Commission scrutinizes all the applications and allows the eligible candidates to contest the election. Fourth, give recognition to political parties. We have a multi-party system in our country. New parties continue to be formed. Spilt in the parties results in the formation of new parties. All political parties are required to be recognized by the Election Commission. Election Commission also has a right to de-recognize any political party. The Election Commission also allots election symbols to the political parties. Fifth, to resolve any disputes relating to elections. The Election Commission has the responsibility of resolving any disputes that may arise regarding elections. Accordingly, to declare any candidate as disqualified or conduct re-election in a particular constituency is the responsibility of the Election Commission. Next, process of election. You can see establishment of constituencies, finalizing voters list, nomination of candidates and scrutiny of the nomination forms, election campaign, actual voting, counting of votes, results of elections and resolution of disputes regarding election. Restructuring of the constituency. Total number of members in Lok Sabha is 543. How many members are there? Seats are there 543. How are these members elected? Every member represents one constituency. It means there are 543 constituencies of Lok Sabha. Creating constituencies is the responsibility of the delimitation commission of Election Commission. The delimitation commission does not succumb to any pressure while restructuring the constituencies. What is the code of conduct? To ensure free and fair elections in India, the Election Commission has adopted several measures. The Code of Conduct is one of the measures adopted by the Election Commission. In the last few decades, the Election Commission has used its powers to control malpractices during elections. The Code of Conduct explains the rules that are to be followed by the government, political parties and voters before elections and during elections. Even the government cannot violate these rules. Due to the strict observance of the Code of Conduct in the last few elections, the common voters have become confident. Challenges in conducting free and fair elections. If we take into account the size of our country and the number of voters, conducting elections become a truly challenging task. The Election Commission has to work in accordance with the law while dealing with these challenges. Some of the challenges are mentioned below. Misuse of money takes place to a great extent during elections. The Election Commission has to take several measures to stop such a misuse of money. Many political parties give election tickets to the candidates with criminal background. This results not only in criminalization of politics, but the Election Commission also faces problems in ensuring that elections are conducted in free environment. Another major challenge is violence during elections. The extent of violence has increased significantly during elections. All political parties should help the Election Commission to control the violence. To retain a continuing influence on politics, leaders give election tickets to their own relatives. This practice creates a family monopoly in politics. Electoral reforms. Elections is a continuous process. The future of democracy depends on election. Electoral process becomes reliable if election process gets improved. Some reforms are suggested below. What will be its effects according to you? Okay, it is given there. First, to increase participation of women in politics, the political parties should give 50% candidature to women candidates and try to ensure that they get elected. Political parties should not give candidature to candidates having criminal background. They should strictly follow the decision given by courts in this respect. The government should take care of election expenses to ensure that parties will not make misuse of money, and mismanagement of money during elections can be stopped. Representation of the People's Act should be amended so that candidates having criminal background would not be able to participate in elections. You can see. Okay. Here you can see the ballot box, and here you can see the EVM machine. There is something called NOTA, means not to vote anyone. Okay. In this chapter, we studied the electoral process from various angles. In the next chapter, we will study the political parties in India. Now, whatever is in green or whatever is in yellow, I want you, the students, to please read this. Okay? It is on your own, you are supposed to read. And then complete your notes. Thank you.